evacuate the building immediately using the nearest designated fire exits outside. These are clearly marked. Designated staff are on duty to act as fire marshals. Your fire assembly point is situated at the back of the building on exchange flags. May we kindly ask you to switch off your mobile phones to silent. Toilets are located on the first floor and throughout the building and are clearly signed. Accessible toilets are located on the ground floor on that side of the chamber. Thank you. Is the motion seconded?
Seconded.
Thank you. Can I ask if anybody would like to speak on the motion to raise your hands now? Ignore me, I'm new to the job. We have an amendment. So, can I ask Councillor Liz Parsons to move the amendment?
Thank you.
improvement plans are moving at the pace. The amendment also clarifies actions for myself, the Leader and Cabinet, so that we can be held to account for delivery for our most vulnerable children and young people. There is absolutely no doubt that the OFSTED inspection report is safe for reading, and it's right that all of us are concerned. I want to reassure Council that the safety and wellbeing of our most vulnerable children is absolutely our priority. And any immediate concerns, as Council Makins has said, that were identified during the inspection were addressed immediately by the Interim Director of Children's Services, with evidence and assurance provided to the inspectors. Since the inspection, we have appointed a permanent DCS, and Joan Tonehouse will join us in a few weeks. We've also appointed two other key leadership roles within the Directorate, which will help strengthen the capacity. We've met with the Department for Education. We have named improvement advisor, who will join us 6 days per month. The improvement plan is underway and will be submitted to OFSTED and DMP no later than the 1st of September. An improvement board has been set up to oversee that progress, and the first internal meeting will be next week, with the first external meeting with partners held in September, and then we'll move on through the subsequent basis. I particularly want to thank our social work teams and our Children Care Council for their reflections on the OFSTED report and the involvement they've had in shaping our improvement plan moving forward. It's been valuable that we hear their voices, and I really do place on record my thanks to them. We're working to implement a new practice model, and a staffing review has been held and the response is being collated currently, and the aim is to strengthen teams and increase that management oversight that we desperately need. We are progressing plans for 6 residential children's homes, which will provide 28 places and provide stability for our children. There is much more that I can talk about, but I know that I don't have time tonight. My best part of the door is open, as I listen to the Children and Young Select Committee. People are quite welcome to contact me for updates. Please, we are corporate parents, get involved in training sessions, attend the corporate parents board, feed into the scrutiny panel, have your voices heard and help us shape this. We are all responsible as corporate parents, not just the administration, every one of us in here. And I'm absolutely open to working with people to make sure that our children get the absolute best and what they deserve.
Speakers for the debate on both the motion and the amendments. Those members wishing to speak, raise your hand clearly now and I will call you in turn. You each have up to 3 minutes.
can you imagine, how would you imagine, what was going to emerge just weeks later? This is not an accident, it's part of a persistent and enduring opaque culture in the City Council. Why is it important to say this? Quite simply, if the organisation does not turn the problem on scrutiny, transparency and accountability, recovery from this report will be too slow and children will continue to be failed. This is not about point scoring. Honest account of failure is an indispensable component of improvement. Why, despite previous warnings, were the problems highlighted in this report so little discussed, so little anticipated? It's blindingly obvious that nothing, absolutely nothing, matters.
consent. So this is not really an issue about finances and about cuts and all that. It's really about not getting the priorities right and spending the money in the correct manner that would protect our children. There's been too much emphasis being spent on children's outsourced homes, and really what should have happened is more social workers should have been recruited and care line should have had more investment put on it so that children can access it and the rest of Liverpool can access if people think that a child might be under serious neglect. So I think it's unacceptable that this report comes out and the first thing that happens from the Labour administration is that the previous member for Children's Services comes out and blames the group and blames a cabinet member, and then two other members from the same group come out and blame the cabinet member. Now, come on guys, this is quite important. Our children are our future. And we really, really do need to deliver, but you know, time after time, you're just not doing what we're saying on the tin. I mean, it was lovely what we heard from Councillor Liz Parsons there, but you know, we do need to start to look after our residents.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor Radford.
Recognised what OFSTED told us. The amendment is in denial. It is actually saying, we'll ignore something went wrong, we'll just say everything's going to be rosy tomorrow. Well, that's not accountability, that's escapism. That is escapism of responsibility. And the other thing that bothers me, OFSTED don't produce a report that's critical. Anybody who's been involved with OFSTED will know. They'll come in, they talk to the body, they'll share what's going wrong, they'll give you a chance to rectify it, and then you get another chance. Where was the report to the Education and Children's Service to say things are going wrong? I don't criticise anybody for saying this council's suffering from a lack of cash. I don't criticise anybody for saying we have an health crisis and an economic downturn. What I criticise this council for is, where was the report to Children's Services to tell us things were going wrong until we read it through OFSTED? That is a failure by this council. That is a failure of accountability. It's a failure to be honest and upfront with councillors on the scrutiny committees. And it's a failure of trust. And this amendment is an action of denial. And I totally oppose it.
Councillor Storey. Councillor Frizzley.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I want to provide more information and just provide more context and clarity for family members. Obviously, it's very disappointing to have our children's social care services judged as an outbreak by OFSTED. Although it's hugely disappointing, it's also a huge surprise as the scale of some of the problems that were present were not really creating as a family member. And I want to bring in wider councillors to leave a little bit more about some of the background information. It's obviously, and it goes without saying, that it's an unacceptable result for the children and young people who are sitting. Personally, as a cabinet member, I'm just concerned around officer leadership in children's social care after being appointed to the cabinet member back in 2021. I was asking for information being blocked by the then director, assistant director, and never got access to a lot of information that was requested. There seems to be a huge disconnect with senior officers and the actual scrutiny of services. And when I pressed on issues such as the previous OFSTED reports and the post rates for improvement, I was assured that these matters were picked up and either resolved or in the process of being resolved, and that we were performing at a higher rate than ever one way. I was also advised that due to our capacity levels within the service and not recruit as many staff as we needed, that we wouldn't be able to achieve a good rating of OFSTED, but that I was provided that that was the only reason why we wouldn't be able to achieve good. To counteract this, I asked the capacity to be put in teams and approve project teams to go in and support the teams that were under the most pressured caseloads. I also approved deputies for recruitment as we tried everything we could to recruit social workers, and to the point that we raised earlier, we've had our own recruitment in social care since 2021 and we've been unsuccessful. Because that didn't seem to work, hence they received recruitment which has been successful at a bit more. On the back of the concerns though, when people asked what happened and what was going on, I spoke to Tony Reeves as the then chief executive and raised concerns. I raised them with Joanne's the mayor, who shared my concerns and escalated my concerns to the chief whip, the select committee chair, and also trade unions. I said I would be on form with the chief executive, as I still wasn't satisfied with the response I was getting from the then director or AD. Whenever I tried to speak to alternative staff, I was referred back to them as lots of detail was kept only with them, not shared with the wider management team. I found the conversations with the former parent and chief executive to be completely ineffective, and he didn't take any action on the concerns raised despite assuring that he would. When Sweet's grand joined as interim chief exec, I raised these same concerns with her, and both Joanne and I, as mayor and deputy mayor at the time, formally wrote to Theresa requesting that immediate action be taken, up to and including removal of the DCS from his role due to poor performance and potential damage to the Children's Services Directorate. As this was a statutory position, we spoke to the commissioners also wrote to the interim chief executive to request removal of the DCS. I want to make it clear to everyone that I escalated my concerns at every single stage, and it was only when she was a grant of action, and obviously that's not something that we were authority over as members, but then DCS left the authority. I want to make it clear that all of that being said, there were some good points in the report, and the work that Susie and her team have done since have been absolutely incredible, and I won't repeat what was said. But despite our best efforts as portfolio, we were all badly let down here, especially by DCS insisted that we were improving year on year, or neglected to mention the issue that we all should be aware of. But like everyone said, this isn't just about children's safety, it's about everyone and our responsibility that we all got our part to play as corporate parents. This is a political and corporate priority across the council, and I know we'll all work together to ensure that this happens. And finally, just on another separate note, I just want to take the opportunity to thank all of our staff across children's services, because this hasn't been easy news for them to digest as well, but the resilience from them has been incredible. And I think working together under this as the cabinet member, we will definitely achieve success. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor Leah Robinson.
Yeah, thanks both of that. And obviously it's been quite rightful, emotional event. And if I come across a bit sober and hard headed in my comments, it's not that I didn't get angry like you all did when we read this report. I do actually want to thank Carl and all the opposition councillors for bringing this debate forward. Now, perhaps we should have had an extraordinary council meeting earlier, but it's absolutely city is the most important thing we did as a local authority. So making sure, not as an administration, but all 85 of us as councillors and the whole of this organisation is focused on delivering our offset improvement plan and fixing this issue has to be and will be our number one priority. Thank you all for that, and I look forward to your help in the coming show.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor Aikinson, do you have a right to reply? Any abstentions? None. So the amendment is carried by a large majority. Right, so now we're voting on the amended substantive motion. Those in favour? Unanimous. Thank you. So that concludes the extraordinary meeting, and we'll now move on to the ordinary meeting.